If you want to differentiate instruction within Canvas, you're going to want to use a tool called Mastery Paths. It takes a little while to set up, but I think the results are worth it. So in order to use Mastery Paths, the first thing you want to do is think about where you want your students to show learning and how you want them to show it. So what you want to do is build a module. And in that module, you'll start with some kind of diagnostic assessment. In this case, I used a quiz. Based on the results of this quiz, I want to choose a path for what my students are going to do. I'm going to ask them to read an article. I'm going to ask them to participate in an assignment, and I'm going to ask them to participate in a discussion. However, based on the mastery paths, I can choose which one of these things or which combination my students will do. At the end of this module, I want them to retake that same diagnostic assessment. In order to set this up, I had to do a little bit of work. First of all, I had to plan everything out and think about the differentiated assignments that I was going to give my students. Also, every time I made a page, I had to make sure that when I was creating it, I checked the box at the bottom that says assign in mastery paths. If you don't click this box, allow in mastery paths on every page, you won't be able to assign them. Additionally, when I'm making an assignment or a discussion or any kind of graded activity that I want to have included in a mastery path, I need to make sure that I assign it to a mastery path. So for an example, with my discussion board, again, I don't want to assign it to everyone. I only want to assign it in mastery paths. So when I look at this assignment, I can see that I graded it. And then under assign to, instead of choosing everyone, I chose mastery paths. And you'll see that right as the top option. So now that I'm sure that all of my assignments and pages are ready to go into the mastery paths, I'm ready to set them up within this quiz. So I want to go back to that first page that I had while I was setting up a quiz. Here's a list of all my quizzes, and here's the diagnostic quiz that I'm going to assign to start this mastery path with. And I'm going to choose this three buttons to edit the quiz. And that takes me back to that same page where I initially set up the quiz. And now I'm going to notice at the top, I have a Mastery Paths tab. And this is where I set up the assignments that students are going to do. By default, you're going to see that you have three cutoff points. Students who score above a 70%, students who score above a 40%, and students who score above a 0%. So you can change these if you want to. For example, I might not consider that a student has mastery unless they've gotten a 90% or above on the diagnostic quiz. I might also want to see that students in the middle range, I want to talk to students who have a 50 or above here, and we're always going to leave 0 as the floor. So let me think first about my students who have a 90% on this quiz. I think they already pretty well understand the content. So I'm going to click this plus button to add an assignment path for them. The easiest way I think to filter this is to think first about the types of assignments you want to give. So the page that I want to assign to them is the highest level reading article. So I'm giving them version C because I know that that is a high level Lexile. And then I'm going to click add items. I can add as many as I want. So I also want them to participate in an assignment, and I'm going to have these guys do a Flipgrid assignment. And let's look for the assignment. It's got to be the assignment in the module. So here's my biomes extension assignment with Flipgrid. And I also want these students to participate in a discussion board, and I'm going to have them participate in the extension discussion because these students have mastered it. Now, I'm going to move on to my students who score between a 50 and a 90%, and I'm going to choose what I want them to participate in. And for those, I'm going to choose, again, the right pages, the right level of reading that I want them to have. And I'm going to go on and set up all of these for all of my different levels of instruction. Okay, I finished adding all of my requirements for each path, but you'll notice that I put a lot in the 50 to 90% range. And that's because in this case, I want to give my students a choice. So if they scored in this area, they get to decide if they want to take the slightly harder path or the slightly easier path. And I can easily change what those requirements are by clicking on this little and button at any point. So for example, if I click this and, my students will now have a choice if they score between a 50 and a 90%. They can either read the version B article, do the Nearpod assignment, and do the fundamentals discussion, or I can ask them to do the extension discussion, this harder version of the article, and this Flipgrid assignment. So I have some different options, and I'll show you what that looks like from the student's point of view in just a second. So now I'm going to click Save. And then I can go to my module and check, make sure everything was set I wanted it to be. Now that I'm back in my module, I can see that I have everything set up the way that I want it to be set up. So my quiz now shows me that mastery paths are being based off of the results of this. And I can see that this article is assigned in multiple paths. And this one's only ever going to go to students who get a 90 to 50. And this one's only going to go to students who get 100 to 90. I also see that all of these are in multiple paths. And this last one is not part of the mastery path. No matter where students took themselves on this path, at the end of this module, I'm still having them come back to do a retake of this quiz to make sure that I can see growth in their learning. So let's look at what this looks like from the student's perspective. Now I'm looking at this from the student point of view. You'll notice that I can see the diagnostic quiz, and until I have this quiz graded, I won't be able to see any further content. I can go ahead and skip ahead to this. So I do recommend that as a teacher, you put a requirement on the module that they must move through it in order so that they must complete all of the mastery path before getting to the retake at the bottom, if you choose to put a retake at the bottom. As a student, I can click on this quiz and take the quiz. My quiz, I tried to make very straightforward. So from this point of view, let's choose to get a 67% and fall into the middle of the pack. So as soon as I submit my answer and my quiz is auto-graded, that grade goes into my teacher's gradebook. And when I return to my modules, I now see that I can choose an assignment group. Remember, we made two options for that middle range path. So if I click on choose an assignment group, it brings up the list of options for me, including the fact that I can see the discussion prompt and I can see exactly what I'm getting into. In this case, I'm going to choose this path. Once I click select, I have no more options. I can't go back and choose option two. But now, once again, when I return to modules, and I look at this path, now I can see I've taken my quiz and I need to do the biomes article, the fundamentals assignment in Nearpod, and the fundamentals discussion, and then I can take my retake quiz.